old pornography porn. I can't hear nobody. I know 2016 was not a good year. Family dropped you. They said they would carry you. But just about the time they was ready to bring you through, they dropped you. The Bible says that this boy, he had a male female nurse. And she heard about the death. It says she grabbed the boy and she ran with him. But in the midst of running, she dropped him and said it broke his leg. Look at your neighbor for the second time and say, oh, neighbor, don't let anybody carry you in this season. Because people will pick you up. They'll take you as far as they can go. And just as soon as you think you're making it, they're going to drop you. But I heard the night chapter said that they called. He said, here's the Ananias that I can show favor to. Yeah, it don't matter what 2015, it don't matter what 16 has done, but I'm on my way to the big favor. Still ain't saying nothing. We about to get out of here. But I heard the Bible say, said it was in the book. He said there's a boy by the name of the Mephibosheth. He's down in Lauderdale. Does anybody know what Lauderdale means? The desert place, the place of nothing. Touch your neighbor for the third time. This is the season. Coming out of Lauderdale. Coming out with power. Coming out with anointing. Yeah. Oh, I can't hear nobody. So I said, bring it to me. So here come the fever shed. But one thing I heard about him, his legs was broke. So that means somebody had to take him. Y'all can read the rest when you get into lesson. So then the king David, he said, bring the boy to me. But in this season, you got to be careful of folk that present you. Because everybody that's patting you on the back, don't think they like you. Some folk is on here for the ride. Some folk is hanging on to invitation. But I said, I heard the Bible say, I'll come to the apostle. This is the season that acts fellowship. We don't get off our beds or do nothing. Because we got to see that the king is safe. Yes! Yes! It's rock. Somebody bring your chair. So he said, bring it. We got to go to the palace. But before you get to the palace, Apostle asked, you got to have your mind made up. Because you're coming from Lauderdale, which is a dry place. I think I heard the bishop say on Sunday, you got to deal with the hammer. Yes! So I can't come out the dry place unless I got a handle. And I heard the bishop say on Monday, is anybody with me here? He said, hold on just a little while longer. Yes! When you come out the dry place, you got to have a handle. And once you get a handle, hold on! I can't hear nobody. You got to hold on till things get better. And then on Tuesday, I heard, can I preach like a prophet? He said, you got to make a declaration. You got to declare it. Don't go for the mechanism, but you got to have the imagination. If you speak it, you got to say it till you see it. Yes! I'm apostolic. He will supply every one of my needs according to my riches and glory. Yeah! Y'all ain't coming. gonna drop the head and it gonna break. That season of the devil scrambling everything my head. That season of the devil trying to fry my mind. That season of the unforced happening is gone. It's gone. Dropped it on the floor, it would bruise. Don't care if it's a red delicious or a green gray. If you drop it, it ain't gonna bounce, but you're gonna bruise. The Bible said he was wounded.
Preach God!
And he was bruised. I put you down. Oh! But guess what? If you know you got to bounce back, I'm going to give you 10 seconds to get on a bounce back point. Look down in the room and see who look like they need some help. And grab them by the arm and say, we all want a bounce back. I tell you what, let me say what I'm gonna say, and we can go out of here with a prayer. Listen. Listen, hear me good. If the Lord used the apostle the way he used it on a night like tonight, you have to understand you can't bounce back unless you know what you're bouncing back from. Now, I got a whole lot of notes that I wrote that's in there in the camp, but guess what? You got to go from the hip sometimes. So, once God, this is transparency. My mama here, my daddy back there, my family here, my church family here. Listen, I ain't talking about nobody else but me. 2016, they dropped me. I was damaged. But see, what y'all don't understand, like the apostle said, just because you wear a cross and a ring, they think that you damage proof. But what I've come to realize is God will put people in your life that will teach you. We understand they dropped you. We understand that you've been damaged. And but one thing we're not going to do is let you stay disabled too long. Because if you sit in it long enough, it will be too long you can't come out. So when you get around the right people that really love you for what's in you, because what's in you is bigger than what's on you. So when I came on in 2017, I said, well, I'm bouncing back. And one thing about it, Pastor Madison, you can't bounce back with everybody. You got to connect with folks that's got an ancient spirit like you. Minister Lee, you can't bounce with folks that's sitting down. Because some folks came from 2016 into 2017 and they still disabled. But if God be not who I am, this in the Aspen, east of this place to our destination. Say yes. Cover every person in this house with the blood. Cover the children. Keep us until we come back again. Now what do you say?
Oh, who's that?